Hi everyone, I am Johir from Johir's English Care. To be honest, I've been teaching English for more than 12 years long. And truly speaking, my goal in all my lessons is to help you to learn English more quickly and more easily. So, inshallah, in the next few moments or in the next few minutes, you are going to be able to take your English to a higher level by learning some advanced expressions with intensifiers. Now, what does it mean? I mean, what are intensifiers? Let's have a look. And okay, let's start with some of examples. So please look at the whiteboard. First example is Rana likes speaking the truth. Rana likes speaking the truth. And where is the intensifier? I think, of course, you got the point. There is no intensifier in this sentence. So the sentence has been written in the same way, but we got a different word. That is marked by the red marker. Rana really likes speaking the truth. So I hope you got the point. There is an intensifier, that is Rana really likes speaking the truth. So in the same way, Rana dislikes speaking ill of others. We know what's the meaning of speaking ill of others. Of course, everybody dislikes that. That's not a good habit. That's bad habit. That's bad manner. However, so Rana also dislikes. So Rana really or truly dislikes speaking ill of others. Or Rana really likes speaking the truth. And in the same way, we can use different intensifier. Instead of really, we can use here truly or absolutely or undoubtedly. Okay, Rana undoubtedly likes speaking the truth. Rana truly likes speaking the truth. We got the intensifier. The next sentence, next example. We appreciate your presentation. Of course, your presentation is so smart. Your presentation is so glamorous. So in this case, anybody can appreciate your presentation. So your presentation is smart or your presentation is marvelous. That's why we really appreciate your presentation. Or we truly appreciate your presentation. So I hope you got the point. There are two examples. In a different way, I have written here. I have also used some of the intensifiers through these sentences or examples. So let's understand the exact idea. Intensifier. There is an intensifier, really or truly. So after intensifier, what have I used here? Appreciate and likes. So what are they? Appreciate is principal verb. I have used here after intensifier verb. I mean intensifier plus verb. So that is said in a different way. That is called collocation or word combination. That is called word combination or word matching. That is so important, and that will help every student to just express himself or herself very spontaneously. Okay, thank you. And the next one, by the way, in a different way, of course you got the point. How to use here? After intensifier, we should use principal verb. I mean before principal verb or before just principal verb, we can use or we should use intensifier. That is very clear. Okay, according to that, I have written so many examples here. First example, we strongly recommend you go to the hospital. So I strongly recommend you go to the hospital. Different persons can be used here before the intensifier. So did you get my point? After intensifier, I have used here principal verb. This is the first sentence. We strongly recommend you go to the hospital. What is called? That is called advice. Am I right? I have also cooperated you. How to understand the sentence? If I would like to advise, I can say here, we strongly recommend you go to the hospital. I strongly recommend, as a teacher, I strongly recommend you go to the school, you go to college, you go to university, you will be studious. That's my just advice. Okay, next one. Thinking. How I think. What I think. I honestly believe. So, of course, we got the point. Before principal verb, I have used here intensifier. I honestly believe he deserves this thing. Of course, if you have quality, if you have skill in speaking, so of course, if I say here, I honestly believe my student, my learner deserves this thing because you are so expert in English. Your presentation is so smart and your pronunciation is so marvelous. Your pronunciation is so amazing. That's why I can say here, I honestly believe you deserve this thing, or I honestly believe my student deserves this thing. Okay, next example. Sorry. How to express my sorry? We deeply regret the inconvenience. Because how to express my sorry? That's why you can say here, deeply regret. What's the meaning of regret? Of course, we got the point. We have ideas and thoughts. So I deeply regret, or we deeply regret the inconvenience. Okay. Inconvenience is not positive word, that is negative word. Okay, convenience is positive, inconvenience is negative. Okay, next one, fourth one. I fully recognize the importance of learning English. Recognize. After intensifier, I got recognize. That is principal verb. Before principal verb, I have used here intensifier. So I fully recognize the importance of learning English. Of course, I completely or I fully just to recognize the importance of learning English, because there are so many learners, those who like to learn English from me. In this case, as one of the instructors or teacher, I completely or fully recognize the importance of learning English, because English is an international language. There is no doubt. We strongly believe English is an international language or international language. That's why I fully recognize the importance of learning English. So that is called know. Okay? Knowing. And wish. How to wish? We sincerely hope. I hope. Just I can say here, I hope you will be successful in speaking English. But I would like to say here, I would like to apply the intensifier. That is sincerely. I sincerely hope, or we sincerely hope, you fulfill your goals or targets. Maybe you are one of the school-going students. You have a goal. You would like to be a doctor. You would like to be an engineer. You would like to be a philosopher. That's that's dependable on your career, on your success. So in this case, I sincerely hope you fulfill your goals or targets. Next one. Recommend. We positively motivate our students or learners to speak English. Of course, we need to give the importance on learning English, because already I have told English is interrelated with academic subject. So this is why there is no doubt. Undoubtedly, those who are school going student, college going student, university going students, every student should give the importance on learning English. That's why I would like to recommend, as one of the teachers, we positively inspire those who are the teachers. Of course, they strongly believe. If we positively inspire them, they can learn English, they can speak in English, they can practice English in their classroom. So, I recommend we positively inspire the students or learners or our students or our learners to speak English. So, I hope you got the point. Before principal verb, we have used so many intensifiers. So, how to apply that? It's very clear. Of course, I gave the examples. That is called practical class, and I believe in practical teaching, I believe in possibilities. Thank you. I hope you all have enjoyed the session. Inshallah, if you practice more than once in the same way, you will be successful in your speaking skill. So just for today, I would like to request you all to keep me in your prayer, so that I can come back to teach you the new lesson, and also see you soon in the next class. Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum.